Hi, everybody. This is Crystal Praxmire, and we're here today with 43rd District Court Judge Longo, who started a new program through the courts to help people have access to Narcan. Thank you so much for being with us today and for starting this program.
Well, thanks for having me. I'm anxious to let people know about it.
Well, what is this program that you're doing?
The program is really quite simple. We're trying to get Narcan into the hands of people that might need it to save other people's lives. For those that don't know, Narcan is a medication that brings people from an overdose in which their lungs are about ready to shut down, that blocks the effects of the drug that they've taken. It's a narcotic, and stops them from dying, basically. It stops them from stop breathing. And brings them back. It's only good for narcotics, or opioids, I should say, opioids, and artificial opioids. Now, we've all heard the news that's been coming out that fentanyl is being found in all kinds of drugs, street drugs, and people are dying of overdoses because there's no control and no one knows how much fentanyl is in there. Fentanyl is a hugely, hugely powerful drug that's used in hospitals that basically puts people into induced comas and for burn patients that have tremendous pain. Sadly, if you are a drug user and you think you're getting heroin that you know what your dose is, if there's fentanyl in there, all bets are off. You think you're using the right amount and you're using something so much more powerful than you've ever used before that you end up overdosing on something and say, I know this is what I always use. It's sad, but the reality is there are narcotics users out there that aren't ready to stop. And many of us have loved ones that were in that position. And we've tried everything as cutting them off, carrying them on, you know, came to live with us, have not lived with us, don't give them money, give them money. Everybody tries to do something to get someone who's not yet ready to stop, to stop. Being a judge, I see the ancillary part of that addiction. And it's hard for families to say, well, I'm not going to be somebody who enables this person to use drugs. So I'm not going to be involved. Well, you can't fix somebody that's dead. That's the simplest answer I can give you. I'm doing this to give us, meaning all of society, a chance to help people before they die. And Narcan is the one thing that you can give to someone that's in appears to be in an overdose. And if it's not right, if it wasn't opioids that they were using, it was benzodiazepam is an example. That's a different drug that can put you to sleep, but it's not an opioid. It will have no effect on them, but it won't have any negative effects. So you can't do it wrong. If you spray it up someone's nose and they don't have an opiate issue, it won't do anything bad to them. If they do have an opioid issue, it will sober them immediately. And that's why you want to call 911 when you use Narcan, because if a person's addicted, they're going to go to immediate withdrawal when you spray the Narcan up their nose. And that's all Narcan is. It's a nasal spray. There aren't any needles. There aren't any infusions. There's nothing. It's just Dristan up the nose. And it works from there, and it works very quickly.
Now, have you been seeing, as a judge, are you seeing more people with opioid addiction problems in your courtroom?
Sadly, I am. And to be honest, I'm not seeing them in a drug-related case. What happens when a person becomes addicted, it's kind of a slow slide until everything starts to fall out from under them, that they lose their job. They get evicted from their apartment or house. because everything comes about getting drugs. They'll shoplift, they'll move from shoplifting to robbery, to try and just get enough money to go up the state fair street and buy an opioid to keep them from being sick. And it's hard to deal with someone's drug addiction when they're not in front of you for a drug-related offense. But I after all the years here watching what happens to people, I found out, yeah, everyone has to hit a low point. They have to hit, you know, everyone talks about getting to the bottom so they can come back up. But the one thing that we don't want to happen is for their bottom to be death. And because we are in a situation where there's so many avenues for people to get access to these drugs, including on the internet, that if we have loved ones that we know that are in that, it could be parents, it could be children, it could be nieces, nephews, grandchildren, the nice kid across the street. Having Narcan will ensure if you come upon them and they're in an overdose situation, if they're passed out, that you can save them with a squirt up their nose. And you can do it for free. We at the courthouse have the product for free. We aren't going to ask you your name. We aren't going to ask who it's for. We aren't going to ask where you live. It's totally anonymous. If you feel that you would be safer for your loved ones for you to have it, please come to the courthouse when we're open Monday through Friday, 9 to 4, and we will simply give it to you along with the instructions. And the instructions are very simple. It's take the cap off, put it in a nostril and spray. That's all it takes to save a life. And with 2,200 people last year dying that didn't have to me is a motivation for all of us to be prepared to help people we love. And that's kind of the story that we're working for here.
So the Narcan pack that you have available, is this an initiative that you're doing through the court specifically, or do you have a partner with this organization? Or
yes, the organization that's providing us with the Narcan through a grant, meaning we get it for free and they get it for free, is the FANS program on the east side that retired judge from Clinton Township started after her retirement. And it's families of addicts, and they work very hard at attempting to help people before they're in trouble. Perhaps you've heard of hands, not handcuffs. And that's the program. That's one of the things that they do is deal with police stations and get them to sign on so that if someone comes to a point at any time in their life that, you know what, I'm done with doing this, I just don't want to do it anymore, they can go to the police department where the closest police department they have, they don't have to even be a resident there, and say, I need help. The organization will send a trained individual right there. It could be Sunday evening. Somebody's going to come and hold your hand. You can dump your drugs there. The police will dispose of them. There will not be any criminal charges against you for that activity. And those people that are there to walk you through the process will get you to a center that can help you, that can rehabilitate the problems that you have. And you aren't suffering any of the justice system issues that might delay treatment. They just aren't there. So it's the carrot is that you can work through the courts, get free treatment, and not have to be in trouble. And that's a wonderful thing.
So for those who don't know, can you just tell us the address of the court where people can go to get this?
Sure can. It's 305 East 9 Mile Road in Ferndale. We're directly across the street from City Hall. We're 1.5 blocks east of Woodward. We had a great big building, big sign, we're there. And all you need to do is come in and tell the person at the desk that you're here to pick up Narcan, and they'll give it to you. And it'll come with the instructions. So come right up, park right there. It's only a few steps. And even if you don't need it now, but are afraid you might need it in the future, I encourage you to get it. It's not going to go to waste. And you never know when you're going to have to save somebody that you love.
Now, is there information on your website about this also, or a contact information?
Yes, the contact information is here at the courthouse. You just call the general number and it will direct you to the proper exchange so that you can talk to one of the probation officers that are experts in this. And again, you don't have to give any names. You don't have to tell me if you want to talk about it, if you want to learn a little bit more about it. They're the people to talk to. And if push comes to shove, you can talk to me. As long as you don't have a case in front of me, you can talk to me, and I'd be happy to talk to you as well of my experience in the past with addiction. Not mine, thankfully, but I've dealt with a lot of folks. We've had a sobriety court here for 19 years. We are certified federally, we're certified by the state, and we are also licensed by the state and audited. So we see a lot, and we have heart open to folks that are suffering.
Well, thank you so much for offering this and getting the information up there to help people with this problem.
Thanks for helping me get it out to everybody else, Crystal. God love you.